Hello everyone, I'm CoolGuy, welcome back. I was lucky enough to get the new Season of Dawn Hunter Exotic to drop after my first PvP game. I also got the Black Talon Catalyst, crazy in-game drop. So today, let's go over the Hunter Exotic boots, the Bombardiers. And holy cow, these are fun. Their exotic perk is Parting Gift. Dodging leaves behind an explosive that detonates after a short delay, damaging enemies around it. Now every time you dodge, you leave a bomb that jumps up into the air and it detonates. And I want to stress how special these are with what you can do with them, and in this video, we're going to explore some of those things, talk about some of those things, you think of this as free damage, because that's exactly what it is. And by the way, right now, a lot of players are using Arbalest, and just so you know, all of them are MLG pros, they don't miss. Getting gameplay for these in close quarters combat was an experience to say the least, and I usually spend about 2 to 3 days on my reviews, so some of this gameplay is forced to show the potential. I work through all the subclasses, and there are a couple of really good ways to use them, but let's first start off with the damage. The Parting Gift itself drops exactly when you start your dodge, not in the middle, not at the end. Right when you use the dodge, that's where it's going to drop. In the Crucible, the max damage that the bomb does is 120. It has to be right next to the enemy, but it does have an area of effect distance. The max range that it consistently gets tags is going to be around 7 to 7.5 meters, and from that range, it still does 60 plus damage. The closer they are to the bomb, the more damage that it does. 70, 80, 90, 100, 105, things like that. This season, they introduced the class ability into the stat, and for the Hunters, when you increase your mobility stat, that reduces the cooldown of your class ability. Your dodge. And this exotic 100% revolves around your dodge. When you get max mobility, the dodge cooldown is going to be 9 seconds. At something like 4 mobility, it has a 22 second cooldown, so there's a huge difference between 4, 5, 6, all the way up to 10. If you have 9 mobility, it has an 11 second cooldown for your dodge. This is a very aggressive exotic. Remember, it goes down exactly when you start your dodge. You can start placing them. You can go into an area, dodge through it, and the bomb's gonna be right in the middle. Depending on how close they are to it, the bomb itself could possibly down them. It could get tags of 90, 100, 60, it all depends. And then you're gonna be there for the cleanup. Most of the time, you want a shotgun or a sidearm. You're gonna be seeing a lot of shotgun in your face gameplay with this review. Again, a lot of it's forced. All of this happens in 10 meters or less, very close quarters combat. A lot of times I go into an area, I know where they are, say they're right around a corner, they're waiting on me. I go up to that choke point right where they are, I drop the bomb, come back. The reaction for them is usually when they see me, they immediately are gonna rush, but they're gonna be rushing right into the bomb. And one of the coolest parts is remember that when you use your class ability in a non-directional way, meaning you just tap the class ability button, it goes straight backwards. Now PC might have to direct it for controller, you just press it twice, as you normally would to dodge, but don't throw it in any direction and you'll come straight back. This has been one of my favorite ways to use it, and it's something you should really consider implementing into your game when you use these. Because you know they're going to be coming straight for you, so you hit the dodge, you go backwards, they end up running right into it. It checks a lot of marks, so you can use it offensively, defensively, you can use it to bait them, it's very fun. It would be different if it was so few and far between, but you get your dodge a lot during a match, especially when you set yourself up for success, and I'll go over that shortly. And to kind of echo what I said a second ago, you know, using that backwards dodge technique to clear a corner that you think someone is at, you run up to it, drop the bomb, step back, wait for them to come out. There's a lot of cool uses. Really quick in PvE, I'm not going to say that it's great, but the bomb actually does pretty decent damage. It's a really fun thing to use for general play. Its AoE with this damage is really good for anything rushing you or overwhelming you. And as far as damage to majors, it isn't necessarily bad. You can chain combos of damage with it. Remember, this is free damage coming out of thin air, so maybe use a 1-2 punch or something like that. And a situation could come up in higher PvE areas where you get rushed a lot. Maybe you're low level, this can keep adds off of you. Think the lamp section from the D1 Crota raid. On to PvP, I encourage you to buy into these when you put them on, when you try them. That way you can use them in their full potential, because if you halfway do it or you don't care, these aren't going to cut it. You're not going to like them. So really consider putting on close to max mobility. Again, max mobility 100 gives you a 9 second dodge, 9 mobility gives you 11, 8 mobility gives you a 13 second dodge, and so on. But try it first with the 9 second dodge if you can swing it, because that way you can have it for almost every single engagement that you get in. Because in my opinion, this is the best way to use it with a high mobility stat for a fast dodge, because I've used it with less mobility and they're nowhere near as effective. And for the most part, you do want on gambler's dodge, dodging next to an enemy recharges your melee ability, but that 9 second dodge is really key. That's a lot of parting gifts during the match. So let's look into the skill trees. Anything that works with dodge warrants use. damage, but to be clear, this is a true neutral exotic. It can work on any of the 9 Hunter subclasses, but there are some that stand out. For the Gunslinger, as of now, nothing really special compared to the other trees was found. It doesn't proc Burning Edge on middle tree, but you can land knives with that tree to get that going for your dodge cooldown. Bottom tree has the big knife now. Those are always good, so you can use it. But let's move on to Night Stalker. Things start getting interesting. Top tree Night Stalker. Turn invisible after dodging is really, really good because you have to think they're getting hit by a bomb on their screen. There's a lot of feedback visually on their screen, and then you're invisible. And another thing to do on that tree, because you have that bomb, it can do up to 120 damage. You can jump up, throw down a vortex, throw down the smoke on them. And of course, with any of these, you can follow it up with any melee, because if it lands for 100 and above, the melee does 100 damage, you're gonna down them. Any other Night Stalker subclass can work. Middle tree follows execution with the melees. Middle tree also has the corrosive smoke. Again, you could drop the bomb, smoke the area. My favorite does go to Arcstrider though, the top tree and the bottom tree. And bottom tree happens to be my favorite so far, but let's talk about top tree first. This one has always been the dodge melee class. Melee kills recharge your dodge, dodging increases your melee range. There is a scenario where you can dodge right next to someone, let the bomb go off, get that extended deadly strike melee. When you do that and you down them, you get the dodge back and you can do it again. And again, lots of synergy. But with bottom tree, you have that 9-second dodge already, but this tree has focused breathing. Sprinting reduces your dodge and get max sprint speed. It also has lightning reflexes. You're harder to kill while dodging. These two things together. First off, focused breathing gets the dodge down to 7 seconds. Insanely fast. You have it all the time. You are being aggressive using the bomb in close quarters combat engagements, and since you're CQC, dodging and placing the bomb where you want it to land, you're harder to kill while you're dodging. It just really, really works. And not to mention that if you dodge in close and land a charged melee, that could down them with the bomb. If not, you have disorienting blow. And most of the time, since you're in close quarters, you're gonna take damage, so combat meditation from the skill tree starts coming in. When in red health, critical health, melee and grenade recharge drastically faster. Very, very good for these boots. A couple things. The sky's really the limit with how you want to combo the bomb. It could be with a last word, a shotgun, a sidearm, a melee, a smoke bomb from the Night Stalker, a vortex, a swarm grenade from the Gunslinger. It goes on and on. You could bomb the area, get above them, then throw a seeking arc bolt using the arc strider. So there's many, many ways to use it. I'm still finding more and more of them, and in the future, if there are any that are super good, I'll make a video on it. So in conclusion, this is a very fun exotic to use. It has a really cool sound. It's a true neutral exotic that can be used on any subclass, but some of them have better synergy. It does surprisingly really good damage. Remember, you control where it's placed. Once you buy into that, the plays start happening. And I like these a lot, to be really, really honest with you. As in, I plan to use them well beyond this video if I'm rushing being aggressive. The way you look at it is it's free damage, out of nowhere, out of thin air. That's never a bad thing. Lots of times, looking back at the gameplay, the exotic is what kept me alive or got the kill. It was necessary in a lot of outcomes that otherwise wouldn't have ended well. These do have a place in the Crucible. I want to be upfront, the review is now over. The rest of the video is just different clips and streaks using them, and some of them are longer streaks, and you see just how much you can throw down the bomb. If you don't want to check that out, that's cool. I really appreciate you hanging out today. If you're new here, remember to hit the subscribe button. If you are subscribed, thank you so much for your support. What do you think about the Bombardiers? Do you have them? And if not, from what you've seen, what do you think about them? Thank you for watching, and until the next one, I am CoolGuy.